Right. Thank you so much for being here once again. Hello and welcome to the 10th session of Creative Classrooms. The very idea of these sessions started in the pandemic, where could we get teachers together? Could we do something for the teachers? It started with as simple as a step on how to use PowerPoint using high resolution images. And it ended up with some amazing speakers coming in. So today we culminate the 10th season. And I always do, we'll begin again, perhaps a month or later, but a few days later. But then that would be completely new series of Creative Classrooms. Thank you so much for making it such a big success. And as we begin, let's go through some of the history and hopefully we'll have people joining in. Only request is keep yourself muted. You can use the chat as much as you want to, so we can, you know, discuss a lot of things in the chat. As we always do, we'll start asking you questions. Today's session is very special because it comes on the lines of something that is very close to my heart, which is integrating the global goals. And I'll talk about the SDGs, these terminologies that I'm using about it in your everyday classrooms. What are the SDGs? What are we going to talk about? And, you know, I'm so sorry for all of you. You have to bear with me for the next 1 hour. We don't have any speaker or any guest today, but that's what we're going to do. I'm going to take up the last session with all of you. Hopefully, you will hopefully enjoy the session. You will learn a lot in what I call, the session is called Goalpost 17. Or change makers world, as we call ourselves. So the idea of these change makers world is we are looking at a complete program where what do we do? For me, the SDGs, and embarrassing to see your own photos out there, but sometimes you need to just be an activist for our program. And for me, that's a dream. You know, it started with a small idea in Sky Education. Can we take the SDGs, which is on your screen? Don't focus on this handsome gentleman. Focus on the SDGs out there. Can I have mute yourself, Mr. Far? All right, thank you. And also, I'll just right. So the SDGs are 17 goals, and we'll talk about them in more detail, and hopefully stories around it. That's what today's session is all about. These 17 goals can be integrated in each and every of your lesson. And that is what I have to teach you today. That is what I have to, you know, explain to you. How do you make SDGs as a regular part of your daily curriculum? You know, perhaps whatever you teach, can we relate with one SDG? And, you know, each one of you can have an SDG that is very close to you. Each one of us can have an SDG that is something that is very particular. For me, say, goal number 4, quality education, and goal number 5, gender equality, are more closer than the rest of the goals. One of you could be a solar panel activist. So you want to speak about renewable source energy, that's goal number 7. So each one of us will pick up an SDG, and that is what we're talking about. Most of you, I think we know each other very well. So it's a little bit background of where and what I've learned across. Well, been through a few places in Europe, few places across in the Gulf, but primarily did a lot of my education in India, Kolkata, Chennai, Andaman Nicobar, Mumbai here. And right now some work with Delhi IIT. So it's a great program. I'm saying SDGs is what I saw everywhere. And that is how we connect the world together. Trust me, it could be the work I did with Tohoku University in Japan or the Imperial College in UK. I saw that everyone is, you know, concerned that how do we make the world a better place? As teachers, we are on the forefront of that concern. Do we now only show a concern, or do we put that into action? You know, the SDGs are supposed to be a 15-year goal. We already finished 5-year goal. And this in 2020 is what we entered, a decade of action. Imagine what action we are having with the corona and the pandemic, the quarantine and the lockdown, the new words that everyone really realizes that there is something crisis in the world and we need to solve. Before I begin, I must thank each and every one of the speakers in the entire session that we've done. Some amazing people, some great friends I've got, principals. You know, it's nice to have principals as your friend. And while I did, you know, every alternate session is where I will take up a session on, say, a tool. But these are some great people. I cannot begin this session. In the last session, the 10th one we're doing, had some amazing people who came and graced our sessions. All these lectures are available on Sky Education TV. Dr. Jaya Parekh, of course, they're great friends. So, you know, I'll take the liberty of you calling the first name. But Dr. Jaya, she's did an outstanding session last week on making thinking visible, which was truly remarkable. Kavita Sanghvi is someone as a STEM educator who was nominated as an Indian nominee in the GEMS Education prestigious award, where it was the Pope who came and gave the award, and she was representing us. Something amazing. She did a brilliant session on science a couple of weeks back. We had Dinesh Bhatija on the extreme right. Divesh is the founder of Unmath, and what an amazing way he teaches maths using Google Classrooms and cities and sports. And he's working with Ajit Agarkar for a new area of talking about maths right now. He has a session going on maths integrated with yoga, integrated arts, integrated with different aspects, maybe cooking. And that is Divesh for you. We had Yasir from Kerala who did a session, only session we did for kids in the creative classroom on managing success and failure. So he did an amazing, remarkable job. And then we had Jaspal Singh, who is a Google educator, someone who's certified by Apple. I think all the domains know him. He did an entire session on Zooming and Google Meet and the technologies that we are facing. So these were the people who really made what today, the 10th episode of Google Class, Creative Classroom is all about. Beyond that, we had we have a couple of announcements, not too many. I'm not going to take too much of a time. But yes, we've got the quiz coming up tomorrow. And today, what you're learning is going to be implemented in the quiz. If you're a teacher, drop a message to me and you can come and observe the kids. But I think it's primarily for the children. So go and spread the word. We've kept a small nominal fee and hopefully the entire amount collected can be passed on to someone very valuable and needy. And that is what our dream is. And today I'll announce where the money would go to. But the Changemakers quiz is to make sure that our children understand the global goals. Every child participating will get a certificate of participation. And of course, the winners will get vouchers and gifts. And hopefully we'll have fun time tomorrow at 5 o'clock is an SDG Global Education Quiz. One more announcement coming before I go ahead. Well, you may not know him personally, but Ashok Kumar Beniwal is a very talented actor. Ashok, sir, has acted in movies. I always say he's someone, you know, there are some people who are like permanent Maas. If you've seen Reema Lagu as a permanent Maa for Salman Khan, Mr. Ashok is a permanent senior police commissioner. Any movie you see, it could be Sunny Deol, it could be Shah Rukh Khan, it could be Nana Patekar, Sanjay Dutt, it could be Ajay Devgan, he is the police commissioner, and it was very rare to have someone like him speak again to teachers now. His is not only for, it's for students and teachers. He's going to take a session on drama and theater, and this is on Saturday. So all of you are welcome again to attend these, and hopefully these are my parting gift as I end the first season of Creative Classroom. So on that note, let's begin. Let's completely dive into. Hopefully I can ensure that all of you are there with me and my chats are enabled. So I'm going to make the chats all there. Let's go. Fair enough. Can I have a couple of people just say, let's go on the chat. So I know that you all are there with me, with all the announcements and all the thanking note. I'm not sure if any of my speakers are here, but wherever they are, it's a gratitude to them to make this possible. Yeah, Irshad, this is a young boy out there. I'm sure, you'll go make some wonders out there and hopefully we'll see more of you. So I've got a lot of people out there from Surat, Ahmedabad. We've got Mumbai out there. Thank you so much, everyone. Yes, absolutely wonderful. Let's jump into it. How are SDGs related to our life? This is something which is so important to me. And this is a story. Remember, we will remember stories. We'll forget the statistics. You'll forget 17 goals. You'll forget the names about it. But you'll not forget the stories I tell you or stories anybody tells you. This is a story of a year which is almost 100 years plus from today. 1914, very cold European winter. It is December. And you can imagine the amount of cold. It's snowing out there. And these are people living, they're away from their voices. Okay, hold on. I'll just...
Voice is loud enough.
These are people who are completely away from their homes. Is it good enough? Can you just quickly let me know if I'm audible and you're... And they're fighting for a war they have not even enrolled. These people are the soldiers of the British Army, the French Army, the German Army, and they're fighting what we now today know as the World War I. Something strange happened. On that, December morning, it is now 25th of December. It's Christmas Eve. And the German soldiers, the French, the British soldiers are in the trenches, doing battles and gunfires. Something strange happened that time, and suddenly there was a carol, Christmas carol being played. So the Germans started playing the Christmas carol, and when the British and the French heard it, they started responding to it. One brave soldier stood up, and he went and crossed the trench. And imagine, it is a war situation. The countries, the Axis and the Allies, all are at war, and one soldier gets up, and he's going out there, and the entire battalion gets up. Somebody finds a football and there is a game of football happening. this is the most amazing thing I can show you. Let me, even before I speak more about it, let me show you the video. They've animated it into something amazing, and hopefully you'll understand what are we talking about.
Jenkins, open.
No.
Otto. Pleased to meet you, Otto.
Freut mich.
Rose, she's called.
Schön. Schön.
This is a small example of what I wanted to share with you. It takes one effort, it takes one soldier, it takes one step to make a difference in the world. This is one of the most amazing stories that you can tell your students, those history teachers you're talking about. This is actual ball that was used in the First World War, where 1914, one Christmas day, somebody decided to go and step outside. We'll end the entire thing. We'll tie up with the same story, and hopefully you will understand it takes one goal, one child to understand the goal and make a difference in their lives. Hopefully all of you are with me and you're understanding what you're talking about. Which goal am I talking about? In the SDG, there's 17 goals. And when I talk about this, it is what I'm sharing you is goal number 16. You know, it is sometimes you realize that we are in the height of the Cold War. There was an amazing song that was written which says, they love the children too. And this Cold War was between the Americans and the Russians. And then the song says, the lyric says, they love the children too. You know, it could be fights across the border, across states, across faith, across people and demographics. But at the end of the day, we all just love each other. You know, if you don't believe me, read this book by Steven Pinker. This is a book not written by Bill Gates, whose photo is here. Bill Gates recommended to read the book. He says, the better angels of our nature in the time we're living today. I know it's a very bold statement to make in the time of the pandemic, but he says, Steven Pinker says, this is perhaps the best time to ever live. Why? Because the violence have decreased. People are more aware. And trust me, this is what we're telling ourselves. If you don't believe me yet, read the book I'm reading with my daughter every night called The Horrible History of the World. And then you will read about people like, you know, Ivan the Terrible, Genghis Khan, Hitler, the people who did atrocities, and you realize that that was a time where you could go out and not realize it. When are you coming back home? Trust me, this is what we are going about. This is the first goal, just an introduction to a goal, goal number 16. I could have told you the statistics, I could have told you the violence, I could have told you anything, but I told you a story. A story of First World War when one soldier decided to take one step and look at the way it changed. Unfortunately, the journals did not think that way and the war still continued, but it's all about us. These are the introduction to the 17 goals I'm talking about. Well, you know, this is what I'm saying, the change makers world. When I say about the change makers of world, you know, there is an amazing award that's given every year to people, to nations who have done some amazing work. And as an Indian, we are so proud that our Prime Minister received one of the Change Makers Award. This is a Change Makers Award we're talking about for Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. Well, does it mean our country is absolutely clean? Does it mean in Mumbai you don't have to swim like a Titanic when the potholes are all covered up? Does it mean the plastics are still not being used? Does it mean animals are not hunted? Or you should go and look at what's happening to the flooded areas right now or the migrant areas right now. It does not mean that we are completely perfect. It means we have made the first step. And that makes us proud that yes, the change makers world starts with us. You know, we all want to change the world, don't we? But sometimes we realize if we change ourselves, maybe our families, maybe our cities, maybe our states, and then the nation, the world will change by itself. So this is what we are saying. Can we teach the SDGs to our children? Can we make our children understand the power of these goals? And these goals are amazing. Hopefully, with this, you will understand what an SDG is all about. Today, if you pick up any newspaper, by the way, there's no delivery of newspapers, so you might be reading them online. But if you look at the headlines of a newspaper, you will find the SDGs. You know, for example, if you're talking about anything that's happening with New World, you know, Reliance, the Jio Meet has come in, or they're making a collaboration with Facebook, or Elon Musk is testing new car. It's goal number 9, industry, innovation, and infrastructure. Or it could be something which is very good happening in the woman empowerment, or the Fair and Lovely, the cream, have dropped the word fair. It is so unfair all the years. That's goal number 5, gender equality. Or it could be what we just spoke about, you know, anything that brings less violence, more peace towards nations. Goal number 16, peace, justice. Or it could be as simple as goal number 1 or goal number 2, reducing, you know, zero hunger, no poverty. You pick up a newspaper and you'll find goals across. And that is exactly what we are, the Sustainable Development Goals. When I started the session, some of you may completely unaware what SDGs are. And my only hope, my only program's goal is, I wish you learn the 3 acronyms that will change the world 10 years from now. The SDG, Sustainable Development Goals. Well, what is life without a good goal, isn't it? I'm sure all the language teachers and all the students who paid attention in the language class know the story of Alice in the Wonderland. Do we? Alice was chasing a bunny. And what happened to the Alice? Alice, while chasing this rabbit, she fell in a hole. The sinkhole, as you call it. And down, down, down the little girl goes. She, you know, there's a whole drama. She opens up some door. She drinks some tonic. And the tonic falls. And she becomes small. At the end of the day, she gets up and she meets a cat. And while she's talking to the Cheshire Cat, Alice is asking a question. She's saying, where does this road lead to? And the cat says, Alice, where do you want to go? And Alice said, it doesn't matter, you know, I don't care. And the cat says, it does not matter where the road leads to. Well, that's for how our lives are. If you don't understand the goal, if you don't know what the goal is about, perhaps you will never be able to understand what the world needs from you. Well, let me not do too much of conversation now, and that's how we expect our sessions to be. In Creative Classroom, I'll have some games, some quizzes for you. So here is a small question for you. How amazing it would be if you could go back, isn't it? Imagine if all of us could be forever 17, right? If we can just be young enough. And as teachers, I think some of us now are becoming more younger with the technology, isn't it? But the fact is, you cannot go back, right? You cannot go back and change the world. So instead of going back, can we look at a new word called feed forward? Oh yes, I know some of you teachers are still young enough. Thanks, and just I need to ask your spouses about it. Otherwise, you believe you are young and what you believe you are. But how about doing a little feed forward? you know, instead of going back, let us look at 5-10 years from now. I ask you a simple question, a question that really, if I ask myself, I'm embarrassed to answer. The question is, will your health be the same or better, or will it be less, you know, from what it is today, if I'm looking at it? What kind of health am I looking at? 5 years from now, will you be as healthy as you are now, or you will be, you know, less healthier, or you'll be same? Just go ahead and answer. What kind of health are you looking at? Today, you are healthy, you're going around. 5 years from now, what will you be? And if you're like me, I'm getting some answers privately, perhaps most of you are embarrassed to say, maybe most of you are, no, if you are not, and thank you so much for being a little optimistic out there. If you know what you're going to do with it, if you maintain it, isn't absolutely fine. If you're going to your Zumbas and Arabic classes, but the way you are leading your life today, I think, yes, I agree with you, will be less healthy. My favorite author, Yuval Harari, says, sugar is more dangerous than gunpowder. You know, the gunpowder that you use, it's today's gunpowder is sugar. And trust me, sugar is everywhere. From ketchup to the donut to the chocolate truffle, we are looking at health. Perhaps, you know, we don't realize what we are doing it. So there was an amazing app you're talking about, which was called the Face app. I don't know how many of you use the Face app. Thank you so much, Shabana ma'am, for reducing your sugar out there and trying to be healthy. There was a Face app. I don't know how many of you tried about it, but these youngsters would be enjoying the Face app and they would come back and they would try to... Hold on. Mr. Vaji, can you please unmute yourself? Right, thank you. So there was a Face app which said that how would you look 10 years from now? I'm sure you can recognize this gentleman. And I thought I'll make this Face app for the world around us. I don't know if you've tried it, but every single teenager who wants to be popular and famous use the Face app. And so do the celebrities. Who is this? Who is this young man who looks a little older after? Oh, right. Thank you so much. He is?
Mark Zuckerberg.
Right. Thank you so much. It's Mark Zuckerberg we're talking about. So I thought I'll show you a little more Face app funny things. And these are some of the people who were, you know, I think we all recognize who Lionel Messi is or Vladimir Putin is. This gentleman is supposedly the most handsome man in the world. Of course, after me, it's Brad Pitt. And my favorite, it's, all right, who is this young guy with a goatee? Right, Javed, sir. I know, a Game of Thrones fan. He's Tyrion Lannister. Peter Dinklage, by the way, the famous dwarf from the series The Game of Thrones by George R.R. Martin. And we got our own cricketers becoming, it was Dhoni and Virat Kohli, and we had Donald Trump, except perhaps for Anil Kapoor. They said that they tried to put Anil Kapoor on a Face app and nothing changed. Right. Okay, I'll give you a quiz on Face app and then you will understand what the whole thing about. Who is this actor? I almost gave you away. Who is this actor out there? Oh, by the way, he looks like Anil Kapoor, so don't tell me Anil Kapoor, and please, yeah. All right.
Leonardo DiCaprio. Right.
Wonderful. I've got some amazing stars out there. Yes, he is Leonardo DiCaprio. And any SDG activist, and these are small side notes I always do. If you want to talk about climate change, please watch his movie, The Revenant. The first Oscar Academy Award that Leonardo DiCaprio got was The Revenant. Of course, there are better movies like Inception and the things he's done in Aeronaut. I think there's a movie on the aircraft. A lot of movies that Leonardo's done. But his movie is instrumental in talking about the climate change. So thank you so much. He is Leonardo DiCaprio. Now, there was something amazing that happened. Somebody took up the Earth as we see, and they tried to put the Earth in the Face app, and this is what happened. And they called it sarcastic, but I think it's a reality. It is sad reality of what we're doing, but this is the world we saw. You know, if you look at what we call the blue dot, unfortunately, this blue dot is no more blue anymore. You know, the Earth was dark brown. If the Face app was real, this is what Earth will be in 2030. 2030, 10 years from now, I got a more beautiful picture, a cartoon picture of Earth, which says the Earth will be, all the green and the blue will be converted into brown and light and dark shades of Earth, as in deserts and barren lands. Let's not make the Earth this dark and black, and that is why we need the SDGs. The SDGs are for us. You know, sometimes using humor, using sarcasm, you can teach a lot of it. And this was my way of telling you the SDGs. You know, you and I will look old. At least we don't want the same thing to happen to Earth. Well, a little background. Let's no more. Too much of history is boring in a class like this. But a little background they were talking about. It started with 15 years of MDG, the Millennium Development Goals. After 15 years, the United Nations realized that there need to be some better action, a little more action. And that is when the 17 goals became a part. imagine getting 189 countries sign up and agree on the 17 goals. Not one country said, no, we don't believe in the goals. And that was a remarkable achievement itself. The only time I think, perhaps other than the Olympics and the FIFA World Cup, where all the countries are participating is this. So these 17 goals became the de facto. And you know, the day you open your schools, your institute, please take a printout. These are some lovely, colorful goals and stick them on your corridors and tell your children, we are an activist. We are an SDG school. We believe in the goals and we want to make these goals a part of us. And then you can pick up one of these goals and become a champion of what the goals are about. I thought, let me teach these goals to you in a little more funnier way, a little more smarter way. How about wrapping our life to understand the goals? Are we going good? Can I quickly ask you, what is that one goal you think you want to be an activist about? The 17 goals are out there on your screen. Tell me which goal would you be a part of? Go ahead, use your chat and tell me and I'll show you a little wonderful experiment out there. Okay. Goal number 5, I get it. What else? Interesting, I get climate change, that's goal number 13, absolutely wonderful. Goal number 11, all right, the sustainable city. Goal number 4, good education, quality education, wonderful. Peace and justice, absolutely. Good health, I'm so proud of the way you're using your goals. At least today, you are going back with one goal. Oh, I'm so happy. Goal number 10, which is the refugee crisis, the migrant labor problem, it's called reduce inequalities. These are some of the powerful goals we're talking about. So let me show you another lovely video, which will tell us what these goals are all about in a very interesting way. And hopefully, you know, it's a good detour for us to understand the goals. Another 2 minutes of video on what these goals are all about.
The United Nations is an organization with goals of peace and sustainable development around the world. Their mission is huge, but we're breaking it down in 2 minutes. 17 sustainable development goals. Let's get to them, because the more you know. Look, in some corners of the world today, people are living on a dollar a day. Hey, that's not how it ought to be. So goal one, eliminate poverty. And goal two, root out hunger across the globe. There's 800 million people hungry, if you want to know. Number three is health and well-being, and getting people the health care that they need. In learning in school are the heart of goal four. Education opens up minds and doors. Goal number 5 is empower girls and women so they can have the same rights that men are given. Number 6, people need water that's clean. Poor sanitation can't spread disease. Carbon free energy is goal number 7, and how to achieve it is a question that's pressing. But if we put our minds together and work hard, we can find a solution, I'm guessing. 17 sustainable development goals to improve life all around the globe. Protecting human health and the environment. Whatever bed we make, we gon' have to lie in it. 17 sustainable development goals to improve life all around the globe. Protecting human health and the environment. Whatever bed we make, we gon' have to lie in it. Now imagine that you work all day for no pay. Economic growth and decent work is goal 8. Goal number 9 is to foster innovation and infrastructure and industrialization. Goal number 10, inequality reduction. 11 is sustainable city construction. 12, well, that's sustainable consumption, so what we use matches up with production. Goal 13 calls for urgent action to combat climate change, because we know it's happening. 14, protect life under seas. 15, protect life on land. Goal 16 is for peace and justice all over the planet, they're in high demand. And the final goal, number 17, is the critical factor, the heart of the machine. It's the strength in the way we achieve these goals of sustainable development around the globe. Yo. 17 sustainable development goals to improve life all around the globe. Protecting human health and the environment. Whatever bed we make, we gon' have to lie in it. 17 sustainable development goals to improve life all around the globe. Protecting human health and the environment. Whatever bed we make, we gon' have to lie in it.
Right there. So these are the 17 goals, like a yo way we had to show it to you. And hopefully you will take these goals further. And that is where our entire purpose of the entire program is about, that these goals should not be limited to a good workshop or a session where we are enjoying it, but you can put it in your lesson plans, you can put it in your conversations, in your workshops, in your storytelling, and let's make these goals real. So this is the first half. We've just completed half an hour of our session. In the next half of it, I'll tell you how and what goals can we implement. You know, take small examples of where do we use these goals. Let's take an example of how does the SDG help organizations. You know, for example, Apple or Olympics or Uber, do SDG also affect them? Apple has a new product coming up. Which kind of goal do you think is important for Apple? So go ahead, use your chat, and we have some more quizzes coming your way. So which goal do you think Apple should be looking into when they have a new product being launched? So you have your 17 goals. If you want, I can go back to your goals and I can ask you the question. Here is your screen and I have a question. What goal? All right, thank you so much. I've got goal number 9, innovation. That's what Apple should be looking at. Absolutely brilliant. Let's say there is a huge Olympics happening in your town. In fact, the first time in the history, the Olympics were canceled because of nothing. You know, the pandemic caused a lot of sporting events to be canceled. The IPL, the Wimbledon, the Olympics, right? Okay, I'm getting goal number 8, goal number 3. Could be good health, could be goal number 8. Absolutely great. Jobs and economic growth for the city. What else can Olympics stand for? Something bigger than that. The Olympics. If there is an Olympic happening, how does the United Nations SDG, the sustainable goal, stand for? All right, reduce inequality. There is something about inequality in Olympics. I can talk about it. Oh, wonderful. I've got responsible consumption. Absolutely right. On the dot. Thank you so much, Shabana ma'am. And all of you out there, Aisha ma'am says, Mehveshman says goal 11. You see, Olympic encompasses everything. There is growth. When a city does Olympic, there are cities being made and you expect a sustainable city happening. But more importantly, you're also looking at partnership for goals. And Olympic is where all the countries come together, the sporting unit, you know, the kind of camera there that's happening Olympics, we're looking at a goal like that. Or what about Uber? How can Uber help the SDGs? What kind of goals do Uber can fulfill? You know, Ubers have a lot of cars. So I'm giving you a hint out there. All right, no hunger, but what else? More specifically, good job, absolutely fine. Good job is great for Uber. Ashraf sir, maybe gender equality would not fall into Uber unless they have women drivers coming in. Climate change, absolutely close to it. Yeah, Shaista ma'am, thank you. Teaches global perspective, by the way. And Shabana ma'am, right there on the dot. The number goal number 12 could be responsible consumption. So the cars are something that they make sure that these are, and it's not limited to them. It could be any of these, but these are some of the common goals you associate with, say, organization like that. So Uber, you know, and that is where you pressurize a company. You know, the way we don't buy leather goods anymore because they are against goal number 15. You don't buy ivory or you don't buy hino horns, right? Because poaching is against, that's goal number 15. You look at the goals and you tell them, if a company is not responsible, for example, Amazon had a big issue with goal number 8, decent job. They were not paying enough wages. And because of goal number 8, Amazon was forced to restructure its hierarchy and the workplace. This is how goals are affected. Well, they are very far away. Uber, Olympics, Apple, the only closest thing to me is when I book an Uber cab, or I watch Olympics, or I buy an iPhone. How about something closer to us? Let us look at the goals all around. So all of us can be part of it. It could be institutions, it could be corporates, it could be individuals, it could be schools and people like us. But more importantly, the goals affect the future generation. You know, I'll give an example, another story of this amazing person. His name is Scott Harrison. Scott Harrison went on a tour to Africa and in Somalia and in Sudan and in cities like that and countries like these. He saw that women were traveling miles to just get, a pitcher of water. Very interestingly, he told a story that made it effective. Imagine a 12-year-old girl, she has a choice. This 12-year-old girl has a choice. She can walk down to school or she can go 20 miles one way to fetch a pail of water. It's not the Jill that we know. So she's going 20 miles. Not only is this girl going 20 miles, she's going barefoot because she has got, forget shoes, she's not got decent slippers. Not only she is not wearing slippers, she's having a little baby brother on her back because the mother is too ill or she has to cook for the entire family. Now, when she reaches the water source, look at the water, and this is how the ad was. The water is as dirty as what you see in a milk bottle. But there's no option. She fills this bacteria and dirty water in her pot, and she's going back. But because she's going all the way with a baby brother on her back, she's tired, it's almost evening, and hyenas are waiting to pounce on her if she's weak. Now think, just by providing one good pump or hand pump or water facility, you're changing the entire story, the entire narrative of this little girl in some sub-Saharan African village. This is goal number three. And when you give this as an exercise to your children, you will see charts like that. What can be done? It's just an illustration that I'm sharing with you. All the presentations, absolutely, Kanta ma'am. Sometimes we don't understand how blessed we are. You know, this amazing actor, Matt Damon, there was this ASL. You know, it's called Ice Bucket Challenge. You know, you had to use an ice bucket and pour water on yourself to raise money. Matt Damon did something amazing. He not only used the ice bucket challenge, he used the bucket from his commode, from the toilet part. It looks yucky, but he says the water in American toilets is so clean that not only can we drink it, we take bath with it. It is better than the water that the people in Africa are drinking. The water you flush is cleaner than the water this girl was drinking in Africa. Do you understand metaphors? That's how metaphors are all about. Right, let's do a little game again, a quiz with you. Let's look at a better goal now, a different goal. We got goal number 16, we saw goal number 3. Now let's look at another goal out there. Quickly, look at your chats and tell me which countries do these people belong to. So I've given you a hint out there. If you don't know the countries, I'll tell you the countries. It's North Korea and South Korea, right? So the male is from which country and the female is from which country. Quickly look at your chats and please answer. I want 5 to 7 answers at least. You've got good number of people out there attending. So let's quickly look at the chats out there. Which country? All right. Thank you so much. So quickly, can I get some more? The male is from North Korea. The female is from, obviously, then there's only 2 options. Can I get some more quickly? All right. The Korea is a good answer. Male is North Korea. So everyone says male is from North Korea. Right. Javed sir says the girl is from South Korea. Great enough. Anyone else? Thank you, Sunanda ma'am. You just mentioned Korea. Which Korea? Okay, the female is a South Korean. Fantastic. All right. Great, great, great. I'll give you another question now. Now tell me about these 2 girls. All right. One is the Republic of China, the People's Republic of China. You can just write China. The other one, obviously, is the Japanese flag. So you can tell me the child and the girl. The lady is from where and the child is from where. So let's ask the question, where is the child from? China or Japan? Write your answers here now. Where is the child from, China or Japan? All right, thank you. The child is from China, most of you says. All right, Ashraf sir. Okay, Priyanka ma'am, the child is from China. Everybody agrees the child is from China. Thank you so much, Muskan ma'am, Majibin ma'am. All of you, I get your answers, some of you in privately, right? Okay, I pounce on this, so I get your answers. And what am I going to teach you with this now? Thank you so much for helping with the answers. And I apologize because I did a little bit of Googling. What I did to you, thank you so much. This is exactly what I was looking at. Thank you for all the answers you told me. And it is truly sad that we could not recognize our fellow Indians, didn't we? And there you are. They were all from Northeast India. They were all from the country we belong together to. It could be the child, this lady out there, this gentleman out there. And this is the goal that we're missing out on. What goal am I talking about? Well, you don't want these people, you don't want them to tell you that I need to have my voter's card or I want to paint my face with an Indian flag to be called an Indian. Isn't it? Isn't it so sad that today we don't even know the names of the 7 sisters you're talking about? Absolutely, we are looking at the goal, which is goal number 10, reduce inequality. I'll tell you a story. If you know who Mayank Chang is, Mayank Chang is the actor who played, the friend of Aamir Khan in Dil Chahta Hai. It's one of the most remarkable movies, Rang De Basanti, one of the amazing movies I've seen, right? He says something amazing. He says, just before the pandemic started, he was walking down the street and somebody said, "Hey, Corona, yeah." And he said, "I could not believe what someone was telling me." And the kind of racist words people are using. And there's a video what Mayank says to us. He says that people call us a chinky. And it is very degrading to call someone this word. It's a racist word that we are using and we don't realize that. You know, he says that somebody says, "Aankhe to khol ke baat kar." Open your eyes and speak to me. Imagine the kind of language you're using. Where in the world are we? I wanted to do this game before even I say, how many of you can confidently tell me the name of the seven sisters, the seven states we are talking about that makes Northeast. Go ahead and make an attempt on the chat. I hope you can do it. Seven sisters are the seven states, and I would love to get the answer. All right, I got seven out there. Okay, I got a great attempt, by the way. Great attempt, and we'll learn about it together. Okay, I've got all the seven fantastic out there. All right, I got one. That's a good attempt itself. We're starting one. Okay, and you're going ahead and writing. I'm happy about it. Please go ahead and tell me we know our seven sisters. All right, it's okay to make mistakes. It's okay not to know the state. Thank God you did not write Maharashtra and the seven sisters or Gujarat. We will know that we only consider our own states as the best states, isn't it? By the way, West Bengal and Orissa are not the seven sisters, but where are we standing? Have you ever quizzed our children on that? And these are your seven sisters. The two A's, Arunachal Pradesh, the extreme east of India, and we have got Assam, the three M's that we've got, Manipur, Mizoram, and Meghalaya, the N that we know of Nagaland and Tripura. Some people say Sikkim should be added, the seventh one. Agartala is a capital, not a state, but that is what we're looking at. Absolutely right. We are learning a lot about our own country. And you know, these are the languages we are talking about. You know, there are statements being made when you call someone a Kallu or when you call someone a Madrasi. And trust me, I studied in Chennai and I know these are racist comments that we're saying. You know, there was a fantastic cricketer who was playing for Deccan Chargers and people used to call him as Kallu. Until he realized, he tweeted recently and he said, I felt ashamed that my own teammates were calling me Kallu. And this is someone called Ishan Sharma from, you know, great Indian bowler. Darren Sammy, Javed sir, thank you so much. And Darren Sammy is a gentleman. You know, he's one of the most amazing gentlemen I've seen in the world of sports. And he says, I didn't even know people were calling me that. Imagine calling somebody Madrasi. Don't we say that? Anybody from South India is a Madrasi to us. Sad enough, but this is the goal number 10, reduce inequality. I played a little game and I could fool you. Imagine it was so easy to fool everybody who is from Japan and who, because we just don't know. They have the same skin as us. And yes, thank you so much, Ashraf, for mentioning. In fact, if you look at a recent photo, there was a rhino from Kaziranga who was on a road because Assam is flooded. Where is Assam? Oh, we don't care. We care about our grocery store and our own city and our own state. You know, they say, you know, sometimes when a Northeastern Indian, when they speak Hindi, you're like, oh, aap Hindi baat karte ho? I'm surprised. This is goal number 10, reduce inequality. I hope we are making a statement with our goals, but that is what we're talking about. If you want to watch about this, you must watch this amazing movie that has come in on Netflix called The Penalty. And again, I would love to show you the last movie of today, the last trailer of today. Penalty is all about this North Indian and how inequality is crept in our system. So let's go ahead and take a 3 minutes again, a detour, and watch this beautiful trailer of the movie that's coming up. And I'll share it with you. Just a little quick share. There you are.
ये best क्या है? तुम में से कितनों को लगता है कि वो best? Are you the best? Are you the bloody best or not? बेस्ट मतलब फुल स्टॉप खेल खत्म
सर ये बॉयज की ट्रायल लिस्ट में सर एक अच्छे प्लेयर का नाम नहीं है थिंक यू मिस्टर
लुकराम लेट रजिस्ट्रेशन डिड आई मिस हिम पाथ
क्यों बैठे चिंके
आई सेड प्लीज डोंट यूज दैट वर्ड
यहां तुझे खेलने का मौका दिया जा रहा है ना बहुत बड़ी बात है तेरे लिए
इन लोग से ना थोड़ा दूर रह दे डोंट अंडरस्टैंड अस
ओह गॉड तुम्हें तो हिंदी नहीं आती
मैं तुम्हारे चेहरे पर लिखा हुआ है आउटसाइडर
ये लोग जिस लुकराम को जानता है ना वो हमारा हीरो है स्टार लुकराम
सर वो ऑर्डिनरी प्लेयर नहीं था उसे टीम में सेलेक्ट होना चाहिए था
तुम क्या कह रहे हो कि वो तुमसे बेटर प्लेयर है
यस सर
कल का मैच भी जीत गए क्या बदल जाएगा यार? फिर भी लोग मेरा लुक्स या मेरे लैंग्वेज का मजाक उड़ाएंगे, फिर भी लोग मुझे आउटसाइडर ही समझेंगे।
Right, thank you so much, Kanta ma'am, for the comment. Yes, the two states was equally important, and this is what we're talking about. In the last 15 minutes, hopefully, we've taken up a lot of issues, and I'll remind you of the issues as we speak about. This is a gentleman I admire so much. The only gentleman I think I feel very proud to remind you that I think I've learned from, inspired from. Who am I talking about? Who is on your screen right there, my friends? You know, if you have recently watched some of his statements in Facebook and you know WhatsApp videos, he has made a statement to us. Who am I talking about? I think you see the screen again, and quickly can a couple of you tell me? Right, thank you so much. This is the person from Three Idiot, absolutely. From Three Idiot, Aamir Khan played Phunsuk Wangdu. He is Sonam Wangchuk, and absolutely amazing. Sonam Wangchuk was sitting on the border and telling us what China's aggression against India is. Well, I'm not so much into border disputes, but I was thinking that here we are not even recognizing that they belong to our country and they're fighting for our rights. You know, when I had the fortunate time of spending some time with this gentleman, as I say, the only time I do name dropping and I make myself very proud, the only picture I feel very proud of is spending time with Sonam Wangchuk. It was at Delhi airport. And when I wanted to start this initiative called Golden Sparrow, I wanted to pull my daughters out of school and decided that I want to do something creative, passion project with them. My father was not ready. Even if you grow up and you become 40, your father still think that you don't know much. And they're right about it. I played Three Idiots the whole time in my house. And after Three Idiots, my father and all, we're like really on a high. You know, that's a movie that makes you high. And I said, Dad, you know, you like the movie so much. When I want to do something about it, why are you not letting me? And he said, go ahead. And then the second day, I flew to Delhi. And look at the way coincidence are, things are planned. My flight was delayed. And Delhi airport, both of us are traveling to Mumbai in the same flight. Mr. Sonam Wangchuk. And I was the first time in life, I was happy when a flight was delayed. I was happy when I was not meeting my wife. And I had two glorious hours. And then we exchanged. I spoke about the open schooling. I asked, yeah, Aamir Khan ne jo kiya sach kiya, and he said it's exaggerated, but the smile was the same, the humbleness was the same, the dreams were the same. And this is where I'm talking about. My goal is quality education, goal number 4. That's his goal, but we're also talking about climate change. We're talking about goal number 10, reduce inequality, and that is where we say. So these are some of the issues I'm talking about. I'll run through some more issues I just picked up. Say Wimbledon could be a goal. For which goal am I talking about? When you see mixed doubles or when you see women's matches in Wimbledon, women are complaining they don't get paid equally as the men does. I mean, I'm talking about not India. I'm not talking about African nation. I'm not talking about some nation which is still a developing country. I'm talking about United Kingdom, where still women are not progressive enough, where you don't consider them equal. Goal number 5, gender equality is everywhere. In fact, United States has a bigger problem with black right activism than any other country, the most progressive nation. Well, gender 5 can be applied to very own fraternity you and I belong to. Thank you, Shaista ma'am. Nepotism, the new word I learned. Thanks to Kangana Ranaut. That is the word we are looking at Bollywood. Yes, it is the same gender equality or inequality in Bollywood as well. In fact, the villains of Bollywood are doing better than the heroes of Bollywood. We salute Sonu Sood for the effect, for the importance, for the work he's doing with the migrant laborers and now the students, isn't it? These are your pictures, my friend. These are the teachers' pictures I'm talking about. You know, despite the people that we are trying to be, men are still 10%, 90% of education is female. And you know, we are more like endangered species in education. And I'm very proud of that because you are leading it. But what goals am I talking about? You are taking care of goal number 4, quality education. Goal number 5, gender equality. Goal number 8, decent work and economic growth. You know, sometimes I appeal to the parents. It's not the school you're paying money to. The fees problem, the conundrum that's going on is the teachers who you need respect for. And that are the goals that are so close to us. Well, in the concluding remarks, well, we are big goals, right? What can you and I do? I'm all alone, I can say. I don't have enough power in my hand. How are these goals going to affect us? And this is the best part I want to leave you with. And this is where you will love about it. You know, few years back, Time Magazine, in fact, you know, almost close to a decade and 3 more years, 13 years back, Time Magazine has this person of the year. Every year, they have picture, you know, not necessarily the best person who made the biggest impact in the year, they put their photo in the December edition. In 2007, Time magazine decided the person of the year was you. You as in who? Not YouTube, you. Trust me, I put this as a part of my resume. So in my resume title, I said I was nominated as person of the year by Time magazine. I got an immediate call from Vice Qatar, which is one of the most prestigious education awards. And they sponsored my entire trip. And I went to Qatar Vice, attending on their, on whatever you say. They sponsored it because they realized it was very creative and innovative. Oh, wait, imagine. Yes, Greta was on the covers of Time magazine this year. Thank you, Aisha ma'am, for all the effort that she's putting in. And she's still a teenager. So I believe the power is in your hand. You know, again, another book reference, and I keep giving you these references. Thomas Friedman, a very intellectual author, very dry book that he writes, he said that the world is flat. Today, the online pandemic world has told us that the world is flat. I get guests from Mexico to come and speak to me. I'm speaking to you and you can be in any city, which was not possible or we were not willing to do it only 3 months earlier. 100 days back, we were not willing to do that, isn't it? And then Thomas Friedman says, thank you for being late. He's referring to the millennials. He's saying today, the young people are changing the world alone. You know, imagine earlier, Sony doesn't give you a right. You can never produce music. Today, you have YouTube and you have your own music videos. Go away, watch Secret Superstar. Imagine if Yash Raj Films doesn't produce your movie, you're all down. Today, Netflix allows you to produce your movies and upload it. You can be an author. You know, it took J.K. Rowling publishers, rejected J.K. Rowling and Stephen King, the greatest author for horror movies or the horror books. Today, Amazon Kindle, you can self-publish your books. Oh, I'm talking about a very ordinary thing. One Twitter tweet have changed governments. Look at Egypt, Tahrir Square. Look at Yemen. Look at Serbia. Milosevic, the dictator, was overthrown by simple what we call the Twitter revolution. You can do amazing work. Today, the power is in our hand. This little gadget that you and I love so much. Yes, the little gadget we have our extramarital affairs with, other than our spouses, this affairs. Trust me, these are the gadgets that can change the way our voices are heard. I just mentioned about Greta Thunberg, this teenager. She was 13 years old when she started bunking school. The only time I encouraged bunking school, she called Fridays for Future. For 1 year, she bunked school. She was noticed by the world. And finally, she was asked to fly down to the United States. What does Greta do? Greta says, I cannot fly down. That's carbon footprint. And my, you know, I have enough time in my life. What do I do? So somebody, you know, sponsors a zero carbon yacht for her, a boat for her, and she sails down from United Kingdom, from Sweden to UK and UK to United States. And the United Nations greets Greta. You can see the Statue of Liberty in the background. In the New York Harbor, she's greeted by 17 sailboats. How amazing is that? 17 boats come in honor of Greta Thunberg in, you know, just recognizing this amazing girl. She has done more work for climate change than Donald Trump can ever do in his life. Trust me, that's important to understand. This is where we're talking about. Where there's another Greta happening in Mexico. Roberto, a very good friend of mine, every time I requested him, he's come and spoken to my children in Golden Sparrow. The idea is we are creating a flat world. You know, you can have people from anywhere, from Mexico, from Australia, from UK. So, you know, you can have somebody speaking to you from Kerala, from Assam. You can have people interacting, and that is what the world has become. I leave you with two simple recommendations. One is go and read this book, The Boy Who Harnessed the Wind. One boy in Malawi changed the way the world looks at solar power. This is goal number 12, you know, responsible consumption. Goal number 7, you know, reducing inequality. You know, this is about goal number 7, where you're talking about power. You're talking about the entire renewable sources. This is alternate sources. There's also a movie by the same name on Netflix. If you're someone who doesn't want to read so much, you can watch the movie. And finally, go and complete this course on Coursera Udemy. It's a brilliant course by Dr. Jeffrey Sack on the development of sustainable goals. The SDG goals, become an activist, take the goals together. Hopefully, I wish I have left you with a desire to be an SDG activist. This is all I have for you. Thank you so much. These are the courses I'm recommending. Hopefully, you can get in touch with me. I'll be always grateful for all the support you've done. 10 episodes. When I started the first session of Global Classroom, the Creative Classroom, I did not realize we'll do some amazing work in the last 2.5 months. Thank you for being part of this journey. I wish you all an amazing thing. I leave you with an action plan. Become an SDG activist. Thank you all. Thank you so much. Can we have any question, any suggestion, any pointers? I'll be glad to take, but we're absolutely on the dot. We've got 5 minutes and we'll end as promised always. Thank you so much. Yes, it's absolutely a wonderful way to start a new year for all the amazing things that you've been doing. I think if they're all compliments coming in way, I accept that. Wonderful. It's a mutual thing. You all have been amazing. Again, leave you with two simple announcements as an extension of our creative classroom. Tomorrow is the SDG quiz on the Change Makers quiz, and all the money that we come together, we will be hope, you know, all the amount that we carry is 50 rupees for students to be, we will be putting in into the Prime Minister's relief fund for especially for the migrant laborers. Goal number 10, reduce inequality. And that's my promise. So tomorrow is what we're going to do, a quiz at 5 p.m. for SDG. And on Saturday, yeah, this is the Police Commissioner, a senior inspector that Ajay Devgan, Sanjay Dutt, Sunny Deol, Manoj Bajpayee, every actor is afraid of. He's an actor, Ashok Kumar Beniwal, an amazing actor who's going to do a theater and drama session for students, parents, and teachers. That's on Saturday at 4 p.m. And you're all welcome. I'll be putting the link in the Creative Classroom link there. You are. Thank you so much, everybody. You can always get in touch with me at Dawood@skyeducation.in. Most of you have my phone numbers. You can please reach me on WhatsApp. I'm very active there, or on emails. Everybody, thank you so much for the efforts you put in. And it's wonderful. It's amazing to be a part of this journey. Hopefully, we'll restart this program sometime later. Until then, goodbye, good luck, and stay a SDG activist. Sangram sir, thank you so much for all the amazing compliments that everyone's been giving. And you, I think I take this as a compliment for all of us together, the way we are going and shaping. It's a community of teachers we're looking at. So wonderful. Hopefully we'll see you soon. God bless. Bye-bye.